Hello everybody, welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure in 7 days to die. Okay, what's going to happen today? Well, today I think what's going to happen is we are going to probably run down to here, the town, and we're going to check this town out because I'm kind of curious what is here. And yeah, maybe we can find all the things that we need to build the the motorbike, because essentially what I want to do is I want to kind of build a garage and kind of have that motorbike, your place to park it. I want to kind of use the drawbridges in the game. And so yeah, so we're going to explore this, and hopefully Alpha 15 lasts for some time. And yeah, and so what I'm going to do here right now is basically loot the house. I collect these things because this is cloth, so you might as well pick up the cloth. It will be useful. We have one bandage right now, one pill. My inventory, we have a bunch of stuff that we have to deal with. I dropped my axe. Yeah, it looks like they rebound the keys. So to fix that, the easiest thing to do is to go into your controls and you find where you can drop the drop key right here. Bam. So press backspace to remove current binding. Now it's none. We go apply and we go back to the game. We did pick it up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to equip it and I'm going to hit Q. Da, 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 da. And as you can see, nothing. So yeah, so let's continue looting this. So there's a candle here, it's nighttime. I sealed up this door here because I didn't want... Oh, look at this. Oh, nice. If we had a wrench, we could take that TV apart. Paintings we can melt. Plants, I'm not sure what we can do with. So the paintings we're going to pick up. We don't need that. And so I figure what we'll do down here, I'm going to pick this wooden chair up. Maybe we'll get rid of this thing. We don't need this table here. Just... We don't need that. Ooh, refrigerator. Is gonna be anything useful? Bam, no. Where do we store stuff? Let's make a secure storage chest here. Secure storage chest. Craft. Perfect. So what we're gonna do with this, we'll kind of put it in my classic place. I'm gonna put it right up here on the wall. Yeah, left click. Okay, I hate this. It should automatically orientate itself to the wall, but we put it right there. And bam. Basically, we're just going to dump everything into here. I kind of want to make a run back to the first place where we spawned in at. I kind of want to run back there. Kind of want to keep the glass jars with me. We do want to plant these trees, so we'll need to plant those. Cotton, we'll keep that. Coal, awesome. Lead, cool. Nitrate powder, amazing. I don't want to convert this into gunpowder quite yet. Looks like we have a black leather duster for the winter biome or anything that's cold, so that's awesome. We'll put that there. We do have a bedroll here. I thought I placed my bedroll. Or did I not? Oh no, I don't think we did. Yeah. No, we didn't. Never mind. So bedroll, I'm going to place probably... Where's a good spot? On the deck up top here. Let's see here, or in here. I'll probably just do it on the deck here. And right there maybe might be the safest. I'm not too sure. We'll have to kind of decide that. I kind of want to build a wall around this place, but I want to build a wall that I can attack through. That's going to be kind of what's different in this playthrough. So we're going to put a couple layers of spikes around this structure, and then there'll be two spaces and then the wall will be there. And from that, I then want to make a wall that I can attack through, so I can run around in there, you know, attacking zombies. Looks like we got a leather armor schematic. That's awesome. And so yeah, so see, the value of that was base of 250, but you only get a fraction of that from the trader. So I imagine you'd get about 20 from that, and that's just kind of guessing. So, unless we actually tried, so that's what we're going to do with all the recipes, is we're going to actually, you know, try and sell them. Gun parts and stuff like that, with the workbench, you can combine them now. So, I think with the gun parts, we are going to combine them. We're going to kind of do that through this playthrough, and I'm going to loot that city to, you know, to the end. So basically, for that's going to be our stomping grounds, is the trader and that town. And I think we're going to make a run back to our box, you know, in the original encampment. So we're going to make a run down to here, basically. Where is it? Down to here. And we are going to pick up all the stuff that's in that box, and then we're going to come all the way back, maybe hit up the gas station if we have time, and then we're going to have to make a beeline straight back to here. I'm kind of curious about this road, if it leads to a road that might lead to this place, because you kind of see this road here. So this one might squiggle up this way. There might be another settlement over here, who knows, but that's why I'm glad we got the motorbike schematics, which is just phenomenal. I don't know, but yeah. And let's take a look at the skills here. So the skills, very interesting stuff. They've changed the skills a bit and the costs and whatnot, and I don't see anything different with the, they've added barter, which is a skill which you get as you sell stuff, because now I have a little bit in there, if you notice. So you guys sell a lot of stuff, maybe buying stuff. So maybe if you kind of use the dukes, I think that might trigger it. Let's check the next page here. We got the same old. I'm gonna buy pummel p. Oh, I can't. I have only 7 points. This is one we're definitely gonna buy because we use this a lot. So we definitely use this a lot. So we want the bonus. This should tell you what bonus you get, not what we have right now. So if you just get 0 and 0, there's no point in buying this, right? So I'm not too sure. It shows up after, so it's kind of weird to read this. There's a bunch of stuff down here that you can unlock. There's the chemistry station, which is new, right? So we need to get science up to 15, which is going to be a challenge. There's something you can do which other YouTubers have figured out. I haven't figured it out yet, so it's going to be a learn as you go type of thing, and that's just the way it is. It's the way it is. This is how we do the content here on this channel. It's me playing, and this is, and you're with me along for the ride, watching hopefully, and hopefully getting some entertainment maybe. I don't know, maybe some tips that you might see that might do something different. But yeah, but when I play, I need to make that play effective. And unfortunately, I like to do the YouTube thing, and that's where the challenge lies. Then after that is the editing. And yeah, you know, I might be kind of blabbing about, maybe I don't know what I'm talking about and all that stuff, but when you see a video that I put up, and if it says it's like a half an hour long, the shorter the video get, the more time I spend on it. So, you know, the first episode of this series, right, was actually fairly lengthy, I find, and I even edited it down and chopped out about 10 minutes of that. But to me, that's lengthy. But to get more or less, so that way you get more out of the video, it would require more pre-planning. There's a lot of pre-planning that has to happen. There's a lot of thought that needs to go into what you need to do. You know, everyone thinks you're doing YouTube, it's simple, but it's a bigger beast than what it is. And not to mention, you want people to see your videos, you want people to watch your videos, you know, you do want those people to interact with, right? But unfortunately, you know, a lot of the times, you know, they'll only watch a certain length of the video, and then that's it. So, you know, the chances are that there's actually people listening to this is probably very slim. There might be, you know, a few of you, and with my 200 subscribers, which I'm thankful for, and, you know, the subscribers are kind of cool, and it's cool to see that someone actually hit that subscribe. So someone did watch something at some point, and I don't know if they continue to watch. There are views on the videos, and, you know, I do get about 4 or 5 minutes on average out of my videos of people watching. So I know that there's something somewhere, somebody is watching something, right? So, but yeah, we're going to knock this out here because I want to put a campfire here. This is a great spot for the campfire. I'm using fraps to record with here as well. So we're going to give this a shot. The only thing I don't like to use fraps for is, or the reason I don't like to use fraps is the fact that the file sizes are just huge. Yeah, you get beautiful quality videos, but you get huge file sizes, and, you know, I hope one day that there's going to be a way to change that, to reduce that. So yes, let's eat our wonderful foods here to get fullness up. Let's kind of eat this stuff. I'll also eat that. I'll also eat the pears. Oh, there we go. We get our hydration back. Do I have any more canned foods that I might have put in here? I thought I did, but no, I don't see anything. This turned into glue. Let's throw that there. Oh yeah, I got it from the campfire. So let's make the duct tape glue. What did I say that? I need the glue for creating the duct tape, right? That will be a useful item. You know, you're gonna use that in a lot of recipes. So definitely collect that. Casino tokens, we'll keep those here. There's no point in really carrying them around. Let's throw this stuff into our inventory. Now there is a sorting feature right here. The only problem is, look what it does. I think it groups things together, but there's not really an order. See, I'm not sure what the order is. Maybe if I had other things with this, but see, why is this here and not with the cotton, right? And why isn't this with the plant-like items, right? So I don't think this works. I think it works more if you have multiple items of the same thing, and it'll sort it for you, and so it's easier to pick out your stuff, right? So what I end up doing anyways is doing the manual method and go back to shift-clicking your stuff back and forth, to and fro, because that's really all that matters. So we're going to plant these. Okay, so yeah, so let's make some new tools here. Let's make a stone axe. So this is what I do at night in the game. This is why I'm recording it. That's another thing you're going to notice with this series is I'm going to essentially record everything. I don't have time to kind of do things on my own. So you're going to kind of see. I might cut out stuff. I might stop recording when I'm harvesting and then start recording when I'm done. Kind of do kind of that method just so that way then, you know, you can all see kind of what I'm doing, and I don't know, maybe it might help someone out there how to play the game or whatnot. I've been playing the game for a bunch of years. I'm not like some crazy person out there that puts hundreds and hundreds of hours. I think I put over 400, you know, hours into the game. So I think I know what I'm talking about. I hope I do. Otherwise, there's a problem. Very big problem. So we're just making new stuff because slowly, you know, what people do is they grind the stuff. I don't know. I don't know if that's necessary, really. It's preference. I see that if you grind the stuff all night, like if I just then say I just went scrap, so just you re-scrap the stuff and then just kind of do it again, right? And just remake your items. And what will happen is your skill will increase, right? And yeah, it is, I don't know, it's very valid, and I like that. See, there you go, see, weapon smithing's now level 4. So it works. But I like to do it naturally. I like to just follow the progression naturally, because that kind of makes more sense to me. But, the grinding stuff just gets through everything fast and then you're done, right? So some people could argue kind of like different points to the grinding, and I don't want them to change the grinding so that people that want to do it can do it, and then the ones that want to play the game differently can do it as well, because that's kind of like the Minecraft thing, right? If people might not agree with me on this, but that's fine. I'm just gonna tell you my opinion, because hey, it's my channel. So you basically, it's like the Minecraft thing where you're giving people options to play the game the way they want to, right? So I'm playing the game realistically. Just took a drink from my drink. Make sure you grab your tasty treats too. I always mention that in my video, and I always kind of place it in different spots. So that's all very intentional. So it all depends if you're watching my videos, and if you do, go back and in the more recent ones I've been doing that, but I've been putting it in different places. Sometimes it's right at the beginning, sometimes it's right at the almost at the end, sometimes it's in the middle, all that kind of stuff. That's basically what's going on here. And it's almost 4 o'clock. Let us proceed outside from our humble base. We should be good to go. We got everything that we need. Ooh, zombie corpses are still here. I'm gonna place these trees way over here. Perfect. Let's put one there, one there. Okay. We saw that there's a bird's nest here that we saw. We're going to loot this stuff for sure. These bird's nests we're going to loot because it's very important. And, oh, wow. Look at this. Look at this, man. Look at this. I saw. Did I see another one? No. Okay. So, I'm just going to run straight to the marker, which is to the south. Hopefully, we'll make it there in time. We are well equipped. Maybe pick up the odd. I don't know. We'll pick up stuff as we come across it. So, I'm going to run straight there, I think. Maybe we'll run along the coast. I will kill zombies, but not too quickly, because we're in day two, so we need to jump on everything. I do want to loot the bird's nest, though. That's a priority for everything. And look at this. Look at this. So if we encounter zombies in the wild here like this, we might... I'm going to run. There's always plenty of time to kill zombies. Oh, and we do need food. So let's reload this. Nice. Now, can I hit him again? Oh, a zombie. So, oh man. Ah, see? Why do they run so far? Why? Why are you running so far from me? Stop running. Man. Too high? I wish you could see the arrows. At least my skill's going up. Come on. I think I got it. Nice, nice. We've got a journal entry. I'm not sure what those are. That's new to Alpha 15 as well. So I think what journal entries are is it kind of gives you hints on the game, so you have to kind of go into your, you know, like your inventory or into that screen, and yeah, and then you can kind of you then look what you have to do. So I think there it'll tell me to harvest stuff off of animals, and so to collect a bone shiv probably, and all that stuff. So maybe we can look at that, but I just want to grab my stuff here. So that was cool. So we killed an animal. And we're still heading towards our humble abode. And this way, as we explore, so maybe we should actually go along the land, because the water slows you down, and it slows you down considerably. So let's kind of run this way. I want to see if there is actually a way across, or, oh yeah, that's right, that's right. So we have to follow this coastline. Let's kind of see if it is faster. I'm almost thinking it's not now. Like, I can almost kind of just go across this stuff here. It's like it's not even deep anymore. They've changed that algorithm, I think. You can kind of cross this landmass here. Can I jump? Yeah, I don't know. It's just... Can I run along the bottom? No. It is deep. See, in some parts it's deep. But you just point up, and I'm pressing down the shift. When I let go of the shift, so you slow right down. I guess you could just kind of go across normally, like this. Yeah, I'm gonna make some more arrows here. And I always type everything in. I know you can favorite things, but it doesn't really work too well. So I usually tend to stay away from it. Because I tried to use it in the experimental, and I don't know, it was just... I thought it would show stuff up, but then it would hide it, and then it would like kind of bring it up again, and then it would kind of hide it again, and I don't know. I found it just odd, and so I refrained from using it. I just type in what I want to find, and typically I'll find it within the first few keystrokes. So I think that's my preferred method. Let's see if we can get a wrench off of this bad boy here. Oh, bam. Okay, no. I'm going to keep the zombie flesh, because if you collect 100 zombie flesh and you use your nitrates, I think, you can create a fertilizer. So I kind of want to see how that works, right? Which is kind of cool. And then there's also, yeah, there's also just a bunch of stuff that, yeah, I'm not sure where I was going with that stuff. So I kind of lost my train of thought there. So anyways, you know, I'm just going to run along this way and I will come back once there's something interesting. I'm just kind of running along. I should be running along. Well, no, yeah, let's run along here. I'm running along this way to kind of bypass the town here. And so I'll catch you as I get closer to the base. Oh, look. Look at the little rabbit. Look at the little rabbit. Oh, I missed. Oh, well. It doesn't matter. Bye-bye, rabbit. Swim. Swim in the great waters. Who am I missing? Am I hitting? Am I not aiming high enough? I thought we could take that zombie out. What is that? Oh, it's a chicken. Chicken in the water. Come on. Ah, come on. I need to get good at the bow again. So, they changed... I might be aiming too high now. Hopefully that's in your face. Ah, see, so to the left of his head. There we go. Bash you a few times. Come on. Come on. Ooh. Just kind of back up a bit. Aim high. Oh, they might have fixed that. Oh, not that. See, that's his shoulder. Oh, nice. That killed him. So you get experience for killing zombies. Oh, what? What did he have on him? I'm pressing and hold. Oh, no, I'm not pressing hold to reload. Now I press hold to reload. Oh, look at that. We got, like, some steel arrows. Or, yeah, I think those are steel arrows. Let's see. Let's take a quick peek. Ooh, that's I for inventory. Or not I. That's the informational window. Steel arrows. Nice. So let's use these up. So that way we free up that inventory slot. We're almost at our original spawn point. I'm going to pick up the corn here. We kind of need that. That's for growing crops. Cool, cool. Oh, this is so fun. And I know I haven't looted stuff here, so I'm going to leave this place marked. And we will come back here at one point. So, let's see. Oh, yeah, this thing again. So yeah, so as I get to my box, I will be right back. Hello, zombie. I'm gonna run past you, and we're actually gonna run past all the zombies. So they're spawning here now. Wonderful. Here's our wonderful original starting location. Yeah, we should be able to grab it all. Okay, let's quickly eat up some stuff here. I got the meat on me, so I think they can smell further now, maybe? It might have changed that a little bit. Yeah, I don't want to take care of you yet. It's kind of... Okay, so yeah, we grabbed our stuff. Looks like we got a bunch of things. Gonna pick up another one of these. We're gonna have to create a hoe, because we need to make a farm. So that's kind of the next order of business, is to establish a farm, and to get crops growing as soon as possible. So yeah, so basically next step now is we're gonna go back to here, basically. I think right there, and what we're gonna find there is the gas station. So yeah, pretty exciting times here. So I will meet you over at the gas station or car lot or whatever place that may be. Okay, here we are. So I'm coming to this land piece here because I want to kind of go on land. So we're going to see if this kind of ties into the village up there. Yeah, there's a lady there. I wonder if they go as fast in the water as on the land. I don't think they do. She's coming. You better not go faster in the water than what we do, because that is baloney. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh no. Oh man, brutal, brutal. Come on, so it looks like the plane Yeah, intersects your view, and then you can't loot. Looks like we got honey off of her, which is absolutely amazing. If you hear that squeaking, it's because I'm on a little chair. Oh, what is this? I'm on a little chair, and I apologize for that. I'll try and keep still, but that's one of the things that I would like to get. It would be a brand new kind of gaming chair, so that way it's comfortable. Ouch, I ran right into that. That way it's comfortable, and I can kind of sit and have my back supported and able to create better content. You know, get rid of the squeaks, get rid of all that stuff, so that way you don't hear that, right? So, yeah. I'm going to save. I know I passed by that, but I'm just kind of running along the coast here. There might be roads, point of interest up here, so let's actually, we're going to run past this. One of these houses might be a forge place. This could be a forge place, which would be absolutely amazing. I know sometimes they don't have a forge in it, but let's see, let's take a quick peek. Oh, there's a road here. Sweet, let's follow this road. Where is it? Right here. It's going north, so will that take us to the village? Or will it take us to the water? I know it's the map generation. Yeah, see that? Oh, no, I'm kind of... Yeah, I think the road's gone. Let's take a quick peek here. Yeah, it's going north. So I should kind of carry on north along the road. Look, there's a pig there. Overheating, no problem. We are in the water here. What I'm going to do as well... Oh, I hope he's not going to chase me. Oh, man. That's scary. We're just going to kind of head in this direction. I will meet you as soon as I hit landfall. So we're going to hit landfall here in a very close moment, getting some lag. So it looks like we're coming upon the southern part of the town. As you can tell, there's a road over there to the left from the land, which doesn't matter. See, they really need to add boats. So I don't mind these bodies of water, but developers, please, please add boats. Maybe that'll be a future Alpha 15 update, like Alpha 15.7. Who knows, maybe. I doubt it. But I hope they do, you know, at some point throughout the process. Why am I sinking? What's going on here? Okay, weird. Usually if you point up, you're kind of safe. I guess it wants you kind of going out of the water instead of through the water. Oh yeah, here we go. Landfall, landfall. Come on, come on, come on. As soon as we hit land. Oh, yes. Thank you. Oh, everything's loading in. What is that? Oh, is that... Oh, that's that stadium? Oh, nice. There's some new zombies in the stadium. The football field, there is actually running zombies. No? Or is it something else? There are new point of interest in the game. So, let's kind of run past it just to see what... Oh, a lock. That's cool for the bike. Not sure how useful that will be right now. Let's run past here. Let's run through the place. So I might get a little bit of lag spikes here because it needs to load everything in. But once everything's loaded in, it's good. So we got this. We got the brothers. The brother theater. There might be dogs in these places now. Ooh. Let's run. I'm getting lag spikes. There we go. That's what I want, is that structure. Oh, this is not even... Wow. Okay, cool. There's a house here. We could have kind of held up our ground here. What's going on here? Okay, I'm going to try and fix something here. Okay, looks like it's stabilized. See, that's the problem with fraps. So I think it has a memory leak, right? So we need to pick up these things. Hey, zombie. So what I might do is actually... put the meat in here. So we're gonna loot that, and then we're going to put the meat in here so that way we can kind of do our thing. So come on, zombie. Snap. Okay, just gonna keep an eye out for more zombies. See how the drop. Nice. These steel arrows are amazing. We got these things. Do these do anything? No. Okay, so let's wear it. We'll save a slot. Let's see if there's anything inside here. There's this. Hey, zombie. See if we can hit him in the head. That's the tough part with these crawlers, right? People always hit him in the shoulder. So usually you just bash him in the brain. Come on. Oh, he swiped at me. Okay. I hear zombies. More stuff. We do need to get inside this place. It's right here. Give this a shot. Keep an ear out for zombies. Maybe they're inside. Come on. Do I see anything good? There's leather on those chairs if we hit them. I don't see any workbench though. Are there not? Like, oh, maybe there's a workbench in here. Hey, zombie. I'm gonna let him pound on that. Is there anything in there? It's just a barrel. Ooh, you're coming through. It's just a barrel. Oh, no. Okay. So this is not a good spot, then. I don't think there is a workbench, maybe. Okay. So let's pick up that meat. There is stuff inside to loot. Don't get me wrong about that. So there would be... Oh, there's not really much in here. There's like these chairs for leather. Okay, well, let's pick up our meat. Let's kind of run through the town a little bit, maybe. Maybe we will run along this road. Maybe we'll run to one of the corners. We have time before we have to make it back. So obviously these places are good for car parts. So that's where we'll get our engine parts. Looks like we have a cemetery here. Looks like there's that structure there to the left. What's over there? Oh, what's this? What is this? This looks kind of cool. Look at this stuff over here. Oh boy. Okay, had some family stuff. What is this place? It's like an RV park, man. That's so cool. That's so cool. So that's like a trailer park. There's probably stuff in there. Here's another cemetery, I think it looks like. Let's go this way a little bit. Let's see if there's other kind of big structures that we can... This is so cool. There's like corn there. Huh. I definitely want to go looting. Oh, what's that? Is that popping pills or working stiffs? Come on. I can't see that. It looks blurry to me. I don't know if that's just because of where it is or what. Popping pills. Okay. So that is useful. It's down this way. Just walk like normal a little bit here. That's so cool. Recover some stamina. Man, oh man, oh man. Nothing too special over here. Looks like there's more structures. Oh, hello, zombie. That's how they spawn in. What's over here? Looks like we have, working stiff tools and a cracking book. And a popping pills all within each other. Okay. Let's go map. We might be near the edge of the town, maybe? Yeah, that might be the edge over there. I don't see any gas stations. So that means no workbench. But lots of looting. Lots of looting opportunity. Some more cemetery. Oh, hi. This sucks. I was hoping that there'd be more. Now, I heard that this is where minerals are, underneath these things. If that's a gravel pit, I don't know if that is. That's probably just dirt. Let's walk. Let's go map. Let's go this way. Kind of uncover this part. Recover some stamina here. So a lot of zombies now. You can kind of hear them. And yeah, so I'm going to run this way now. Oh, this place is so cool. Is this the upper corner? Yeah, okay, there is. There's a road here. Okay, I'm getting a little bit of lag here. Lag spikes. Okay, it's probably because it's part of a new area, maybe? Yes it is. Gang lag. I'll be right back. Okay, I am back, and I switched back to OBS, so we're going to give that one a shot again. Oh, you know what? I don't have arrows. Let's kind of reload them with this. Boom, bada bing. Bam. There you go. And That was pretty good. Two shots, two hits. Okay, here's a zombie. I'm just gonna bash him. It seems to work the best. Yeah, this certainly does. Oh no! I'm glad he didn't break my leg. Because they really screw you up. Okay, let's... Oh, nice, nice. I hope that's in his face. Hello, ugly! There we go. Grab him, pick him... Oh, pipe, nice. There we go. I think what happens is you end up hitting him in the arms. That's why that happens, I think. So I kind of want to explore this place, since we're here. Nice! We got him in the face. Come on, come on. Ooh, bam. Nice. Hi! Hi, welcome. Welcome. Your turn. Bang! Huh, looks like they changed their behavior a little bit. They kind of do it, but not as often anymore. Bam! Okay. Pain pills. Okay, that's a burning barrel. Campfire here? Wow, really? No cooking pot in that. I've also heard that cooking pots are now explosive. So that's another new thing. I'm gonna check... Oh, look at this. Bird's nest. Let's check the shopping cart out here. Bam! We're getting all these skills and abilities. Oh, this is so cool. Oh, it's the frogs. I'm kind of hearing, like, a noise. Oh, I wonder if you can take those apart with wrenches. Oh, this is so, so cool, guys. So, let's loot this place up a bit. As best as we can. Can we go into this place? Am I overheating? I am, but I'm wearing... Yeah, it should be decreasing instead of increasing, but for whatever reason... Oh... So what would be easier, you think, to get in? You think the wall, or you think right here? I think this would be the easier way in. Because we would... Oh, there's a... Yes, an oven. Come on, cooking pot! You know this is important, right? So, we'll put the cotton in here. We'll put the cooking pots there. The cotton is everywhere. Oh, that's so amazing. Okay, awesome. We got that. 1,700 hours. Where are we... I think I'm going to head back to our base, so I'm just going to run along this way. And I'm going to kind of follow that road to see if it goes into the water. I'm going to change these out with glass jars, because you know what we're going to do with these, right? We're going to fill them up, yeah. If I find any animals on the way back, we're going to definitely take care of them. What? Why does the road just end right here? That's so weird. Yeah, they still need to work on the generation a little bit, I think. You shouldn't really have the road just end like that. There's a road here as well. Is this a road? This kind of looks like a dirt road, but it's not. That's fascinating. It's a big kind of flat area. Yeah, we got more of these parks. So those flaming barrels, I wonder if they turn into gas. Cool. There should be good loot in there. And this road... Oh, I wonder if this road kind of goes into where the trader is. So let's kind of follow this and see if it links up. I have a funny feeling it does, and we'll hop in the water to cool down quickly as well. Let's do that. Let's kind of soak up and cool off a bit. Kind of walk... Oh! Kind of walk this way a bit. Okay, we're 100% wet. Perfect. Now we got water, murky water, but that's okay. Let's see what's in here. Anything good? Anything? Glass. We'll have to pick that up. So let's see. Where are we now? I have a funny feeling it's gonna stem off this road. There'll be a side road. And that side of the road will go to. There's some yucca plants here. Good. This is where we can collect them. And my athletics is now 10. Yay! That's exciting. So that's why I haven't been killing too many zombies, right? It's just because I have very limited arrows. And, I don't know, I don't want to yet. I don't want to level up too fast. Because if you level up too fast, you're going to have to end up... You're dealing with them sooner, and they'll be a lot harder as you go. I think if you leave them alone, then they kind of spawn those zombies relative to your level, right? So you almost don't want to speed through creating the tools because you're going to level up a bunch of times and you're going to have kind of skill-based. Now, when I mean skill-based, I mean like you're going to have tools, your tool skills up, but then your combat skills are going to be lacking. So you're going to get harder zombies with you less kind of weapons, with lesser weapons, because you have to craft your weapons, right? So things like the wooden club and all that will be actually lesser quality, but the zombies will be at a higher difficulty because you leveled up doing crafting. So that's, I think, how they offset it. So you're more than welcome. Yeah, look at that, the road just stems off. Amazing. I wonder if there's more that way. Well, with the motorbike, we'll be able to explore that. Oh, what's this? This is a military base. Oh, my goodness. This map is just crazy. From military base to town to whatever. Yeah, this looks like this is all gonna hook in nicely, and we're going to see our wonderful abode, and then we'll call it an episode, man. So, yeah, look at this. We're gonna run past our former. What is it? Our former. I'm gonna plant these trees here, I think. We will be back in this area, so we might as well plant them here so they can grow. They're just maple trees. Nothing specific. Where's that bird's nest? Here we go. Definitely want this because it would be eggs and our arrows. Hello, hello. Oh man, beautiful. Is there anything to sell? Hazmat boots. We can probably find better ones. Let's sell them. Oh, I love this. I love this. This game is amazing. Let's do some trading here. Oh man, I still can't get over this. This is just amazing. I want to play this game so much. That's why I'm recording this again. Padlock we could sell, or we could melt it down, right? Because that's worth the metal. But this hazmat boots, we're gonna sell that. So it's worth 1600. We get 200. So let's see. You only get a fraction of what you. Yeah, I don't know if that's worth it. This one should always have the calipers. So we're gonna earn 6000. We need the calipers. That's what I've decided.
Peace be with you.
So yeah, this is really cool. I'm gonna run back to your base. It's 1900. This place closes, I think, at nightfall anyways. So let us, where's the sleeping bag? It's right over here. We can pick it up now. And we can actually scrap it too. Should have picked up the other one and scrapped as well, but whatever. Okay, look at this, look at this. Where's the pig? Oh, don't run away. Oh man. We're almost home. We can see our home. I kind of want to go after the pig, 'cause it's food. We do have a lot of food, so it's not like we need it. And we don't need the hides really, because we have the forge. Yeah, I'm just gonna make a beeline straight for our place here. Ooh, what's this? Bird's nest. Nice. There should be nothing here, 'cause we killed everything. Right? Sensed. Where we sensed. Let's kind of do a sweep around our place here. Or is it just sensed because we have the food on us? So let's quickly get rid of the food, and that might help. I'm gonna dump all this stuff in. Perfect. So I've got everything in here. So what we need to do is we need to make some wood log spikes. Let's see how much they cost now. I know they've changed them. They cost 20 still. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we'll go, I'm going to create 5 because what I always do is I use it for fuel. And we're going to put our cooking pot in place, which then I think it allows us to create boiled water, right? And then these are going to act like fuel, which, oh, they changed them. They now only do 2 minutes, 40 seconds. So the benefit. Is not as good as it used to be. It's half. It's almost half. They reduced it by what? Reduced it 30%, 40% around there, probably if I did the math roughly in my head. So we're just gonna do this to cook. We'll put the rest in here. 13 minutes. They really changed that. Let's kind of cook that as well. And I do want to make some food as well. So we're going to make our favorite. I'm going to make some bacon and eggs. Right? Bacon and eggs, man. Oh boy, 9 of them. That's amazing. That will keep us fed for a while, but we're going to have to go on a large spree for sure. We do have these if we really need it, but I would tend to lean against that. We can throw our rounds in here. These puffer coats, I should have sold it. Okay. I wasn't thinking about that, so we'll take that to the vendor as well. This, what's this worth? 12. This is better to melt down. This would be for gas. That'd be useful. Okay. This is cool, folks. So I made it back. I'm going to just harvest some materials here while that is running. So thank you, everybody, for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this episode. I know I had a great time playing with all of you, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next episode. Bye-bye.